are you feeling, Amanda?
I'm feeling good. My back hurts, but in fact, we fixed a cool problem where this team had a camera issue that was causing their cameras to only load about one frame every second. And it would stay, it would disappear, and their camera would come back. We went in and like looked at like a whole bunch of things, and it turns out their disk utilization was at 98%, which is insane, which should never be that high. And you know, me and Julia Green went through and pushed a whole bunch of buttons. And problem number one, their page utilization of everything was at 70%, which was high. They had partitioned their drive, we didn't mess with that, but we turned off Bitdefender and uninstalled a whole bunch of things, and now it works. They were like so excited, this is the first time they'd ever worked in a competition with their cameras, so.
Wow, that's so cool.
What we did. That's what I was doing.
Wow.
You'll get there, because all those words come back as you keep going through computer science. You done the 370 yet?
No, I'm doing 203 right now.
I think it's 370 over 3. They're like, so how you did it with the tips of the page and memory is like, when you're in Excel and you can say, oh, I want this cell to pull the values from E5, except in memory it's like, I have an address where I stored like, you know, a block of information. It's at E5,
but also like a pointer.
It's like a pointer, but like your memory
pointer.
And you got to move
so
from like your local memory to like your disk memory. And as you move
from your local
memory, it's part of their problem was they were encrypting their disk memory, so you don't need an FRC company, because that's not, like, you know, storing your personal
financial information. What if someone's going to steal our robot data?
Never know.
So we have to find out how many holds their memory.
And basically optimize their memory, like, getting to the disk thing. That didn't answer. But I knew you were
reading it. It sounded very cool.
It's about the best thing I've done all year. How do you check that on a robot? So the thing that... So when you have those slow camera streams, or when you have anything that's not moving properly, one of the things to check is you control the page of your task manager. I was looking for CPU usage, because sometimes when that's high, like, you've got, I don't know, like, 8 probe tabs on top of your guys, which is open, and I'm just, like, less, like, smooth as you books that don't have all that much CPU or anything. That'll slow down your next upload just because the laptop can't process it all, so that's what we're looking for. But the column just looks outstanding, outstanding. And like, then you won't have to find those two. You just this one, it's busy.
This one's still.
It's an investigation.
So that's how you would find it. It's when you see connectivity issues, maybe like the fifth step, it's what else is going on the laptop.
Okay. First step should be your Wi-Fi connection. If that's off, your Wi-Fi Bluetooth should be off. And then you can check your IP addresses. Next step is probably to try the connection again if the computer's gone bad. And then probably look at the laptop and see what's going on there.
Very cool.
Every CSA has their own favorite. And we won't be on the field in this match. You know, like, this week, so.
Why aren't we on the field?
Because we have 3 FTAs. In first in Michigan, there's a very loose distinction between an FTAA and a CSA. But technically, if you're in first, the FTAA will troubleshoot all the connections on the field, and the CSAs will troubleshoot software issues and electrical issues in the pits. In FIMS, because almost all events are short-staffed, both CSAs and FTAs do both. But this week at this event, we'll be here. So,